Nice to have joined at the start of pre-season this year rather than coming right at the end, but the lads returned today, went through a whole battery of tests. It's all performance related, so a lot of physical based tests, some medical and some health screening that they go through, and really just make sure that they're returning in a condition that we're happy with. Looking at individual programs where they've got stuff that we need to work on through pre-season, and really just setting us up for the next few weeks really.
This is the first chance we get to see these boys. They've been away for about 6 weeks, so they come back. There's 25 of them back this morning, well, all day. It's a long day. It's from 9 in the morning till about 5 o'clock, which they're delighted with. And what it is a chance to get some baseline readings. So there's the medical team, myself and Andy Jones, the academy doctor, going through all the physical side of things, blood tests, physios then, looking at the MSK, musculoskeletal system, joints, muscles, identifying how they are, anyone who's had issues last season, where they are now at the start of this season, anything we need to put in place now. It's all about identifying anything that may cause a problem before it becomes a problem, really. And this year as well, we've got a lot more coming in as well. We've got the osteopaths, nutritionists, we've got a well-being team as well. So yeah, look, it's a totally holistic approach we've got for these boys. So yeah, no, all good.
So each player has their own individual sort of benchmark that we've collected. You know, we've had players for a number of years. We get to see their progress through years. We get to see where they are, like according to their norm. We also have like a squad and a team benchmark that they need to come into. So our new players, we like to see where they fit into our benchmark. So we can really individualise their programs and really make sure they're working on the things that they need to work on. I think gone are the days where the players go off on 5 weeks on holiday. I think they still do get a bit of a break, but they get a couple of weeks sort of full rest and recovery. I know the last couple of years especially, they've sort of lacked that time. So we were very conscious on giving players a lot of time to recover physically as well as mentally. Then they have a sort of build up. So they build up through their 3-4 weeks, looking at sort of building our aerobic fitness. So then when they return back into pre-season, we can sort of jump straight into the football side training rather than having to sort of catch up on the fitness. We're very scientific in our approach. We plan in a lot of detail. We make sure we manage and we monitor every day what the players are doing. The balls do come out quite early on. I like to say we are Swansea Football Club, and especially the way we play, we are very much Swansea Football Club. We're not Swansea Running Club. There are some tough runs in there. It's not all, you know, smiles and giggles, and there is a lot of running without the ball. I think football is largely without the ball, and you have to be able to do that running. So we are building that fitness side, but getting a lot of technical work in, a lot of tactical work in, which is a big thing. Again, especially the way we want to do stuff, the tactical side is massive. So it's a good period of time to get the work in.